Hey guys, welcome back to a new video by Biology with Zhang Xuan. So today we are going to run through the Cambridge IGCSE Biology Paper 6, Alternative to Practical. So this is the February-March 2024-06-1062. So the link of the paper will be in the description below together with the paper 4 that I discussed earlier on. So let's start off with this video. So question one, a student investigated the effect of glucose concentration on the rate of anaerobic respiration in yeast. Anaerobic respiration in yeast breaks down glucose to form ethanol and carbon dioxide. Anaerobic respiration in yeast causes the blue dye or methylene blue to become colorless. The time taken for the blue color to disappear can be used as a measure of the rate of anaerobic respiration in yeast. Okay, let's break down what the question one. So they say the first thing that the first sentence of it, even in this paragraph, has already mentioned the IV to you is that the effect of glucose concentration, okay, which is the IV, and the rate of the anaerobic respiration will be the DV. So they also told you that the color change or the thing that helped to identify the color is using methylene blue, and we know that it causes the blue dye to become colorless. Okay, so here are the methods that the questions have been stated. So they've already tell you each of the steps that you need to follow, like label one test tube of this, one test tube of that, then the steps of it. This will be useful for the later questions. Okay, so I will leave to you guys to read this. Okay, so they said that record the time taken in seconds for each of the test tube. So record the time taken in seconds. This is the keyword. The student stopped timing if the blue color had not disappeared after 10 minutes. They recorded this result as more than 600 in their table. The stop clocks from step 13 are shown in figure 1.2. So A part 1, as any regular ATP question, they ask you to draw and construct a table. They say convert the times on the stop clock shown in figure 1.2 to seconds and record these times in your table. So this is a general, of course, the table that in order to get the marks is that you state the percentage concentration of glucose, or you may also put as test tube. And you can also put the time taken for the blue color to disappear, and units is important. And then you fill in your concentration. This can be found in the question here. So they label 0.0%, 0.5%, and 1.0%. Okay, then we come to the time taken. For 0.0% is 10 minutes. But are you going to put 600 seconds only? No. You put more than 600. Why? Because the question says that if the color had not disappeared after 10 minutes, they record this as the result. So if you never read the question properly and you put 600, this whole thing will be wrong. And the rest of it is just simple mathematics. You should be getting 362 and 132. So this is your 4 marks. Part 2, state a conclusion for the results of this investigation. So, what can you see from here? So, the higher the glucose concentration, you can see that the rate of respiration is also higher. So, in pretty much the conclusion is just comparison between the IV together with the DV. So, in the end, it will be the higher glucose concentration, rate of respiration is greater. Part 3, state the independent variable in this investigation. So this is very easy. If you read here, it's the effect of the glucose concentration. So glucose concentration will be the IV. And part 4, they say state one variable that was kept constant in this investigation. So there are a lot of constant variables they have already kept. It's the volume of the concentration of yeast, total volume of glucose, the type of yeast, and the time when it reaches equilibrium. Temperature is definitely one, and then the volume or the concentration of the methylene blue being added. Part 5, explain why it was important to stir the yeast suspension in step 5. So this is another common past year paper question they will ask, the importance of stirring in your investigation. So to be fair, if you do not know how to answer this, just remember two words, So they are uniformly distributed or distributed uniformly. Both ways are acceptable. B. One way to improve this investigation would be to use an increased number of different concentration of glucose. Part 1 says state suggests two other ways to improve this investigation. So they say that the first one is to increase number of different concentration of glucose. So there are other ways that we can also improve is to repeat each of the glucose concentration having added. So the example, we have 0.0%. Why not we repeat this 2 times? Well, if we have a 1.0% glucose concentration, we can also repeat this 2 times to check whether the result has provided any anomalies. If it's not, then the investigation is fair. Another one is to use a colorimeter so that the color can be visualized better. Whenever there's a question that mentions about color, the change of color, and they ask you for one improvement, always add use a colorimeter. Very simple. Then you will get your free 1 mark from here. Part 2. Describe how you would make 5 cm cube of 0.25% glucose solution using a 0.50% glucose solution and distilled water. So this question, I will mark this as quite tricky if you do not understand what the question wants. So the question says that you want to make a 5 cm cube of 0.25%, but now you're only given as 0.50%. So the concentration of this and the 0.25% is times 2. When the glucose concentration is double, the volume will be divided by 2. Because when you have a higher volume of a very high concentration, it will never meet the requirement of what the question wants. So when you have the concentration doubled, the volume has to decrease so that it meets the same standard. And then they say using distilled water. So if 5 cm cube of glucose solution is there already, they will be also be using 5 cm cube of water. So same for this. If it's 0.50%, we already use 2.5 cm cube of the glucose solution. The distilled water will also follow 2.5 cm cube. So the answer is just pretty much this. Use 2.5 cm cube of 0.5% glucose solution and 2.5 cm cube of distilled water. This is 2 marks. Okay, so you must be able to relate the difference of the concentration and how it affects the volume. Okay, because common sense, right? When if you pour Ribena, for example, and that Ribena concentration is 0.50%, okay, but then you want to add till it reaches this at 0.25%. So you can see the concentration is double. If you use the same volume used with a lower concentration one, this will become very, very strong. So it doesn't make sense at all. So this is how you relate with it, okay? Part 3, describe the method you would use to test a solution for the presence of glucose. So 2 marks, glucose is the test of a reducing sugar. So reducing sugar, we always use the Benedict reagent or the Benedict solution. Then we will heat up to 70 to 80 degrees. So adding the Benedict reagent is 1 mark, heating it up is the 2nd mark. So make sure you remember this. Part C. A student investigated the effect of temperature on the rate of respiration in yeast at 25 degrees and 35 degrees. In one experiment, the student measured the volume of CO2 produced by the yeast every 5 minutes for a total of 30 minutes. Part 1 said describes suitable apparatus that could be used to collect and measure the volume of the carbon dioxide produced. So you want to collect and also measure the volume. So the only way, and CO2 is also a gas. So pretty much it's the same knowledge that you apply to your planning investigation, the 6 markers, that you will use a gas syringe or probably an inverted measuring cylinder that would also work. Also maybe collect over water under the measuring cylinder. These are also acceptable, but the simplest answer is using a gas syringe. The student did 3 experiments at each temperature. They used the results to calculate the mean volume of carbon dioxide produced. Part of the student results table for the experiment at 35 degrees is shown in table 1.1. So they've given you the result, and now they say part 2, the student decided that with the result of one of the experiments shown in table 1.1 was anomalous. So state is what is meant by an anomalous result. So very simple, anomalous means that it shows an anomaly. Anomaly is basically a particular result that you have retrieved where it doesn't fit the overall trend. Okay, so for example like this, you can see the consistency, maybe at time there's 0.7 all of a sudden, then you know that there is an inconsistency in the trend. For this case, it will be experiment 2. Okay, experiment 2 is lying out of the general trend. You can see that the difference between this is 0.2, and then the difference between this is 0.1, and here's about 0.1. While you see this one is about 1.2. Okay, something like that. So I forgot that that's the mean there, but then that's just the understanding. Part 3, describe how the student calculate the mean volume of the CO2 produced shown in table 1.1. So we know that the experiment 2 is the anomaly, okay? So how would they calculate the mean? So they would neglect the experiment 2 result, and they would just use 1.8 plus 2 divided by 2, they will get 1.9. So this is the same as the mean in the question. So they will exclude the sample 2 result. The next one, the result of the whole investigation about the effect of temperature on the rate of respiration in yeast at 25 degrees and 35 degrees are shown in table 1.2. So they've given you this table, and now part 4 says using the data in table 1.2, compare the mean volumes of carbon dioxide produced at 25 degrees and 35 degrees. So this one is a bit like a describe question also, where you can kind of state your the results. But then in general, you can see that the results in the 35 degree temperature has a higher mean volume comparison with this. Okay, so this is the first point. The second point is that when we look at the last few minutes here, you can see that this drastically increases. However, in here, it's remain stationary. So this is how you state your 2 points. So I've written in this way. You can have a look. Similarly, you can write something like this also. Okay, part 5, plot a line graph on the grid of mean volume of CO2 produced against time using all of the data in table 1.2. You need to plot the data for each temperature as separate lines on your graph. Include a suitable key. Okay, so this is my graph. So you can see there are 2 lines, okay? And the key is needed. And then your correct axis, your correct plots, they contribute to the mark. So have a look. I give you 10 seconds to look at it. Okay, we are back. So you must use 2 different lines. So 2 different plots that I've used is that I use one is an X and one is a dot, and the one and the outside is just a circle. Then I will still connect the point. So you just look something like that, lah. Okay, so for this is the 25 degree, please label this. This is very important. Okay, this one is needed. And also to label the 25 degrees also, and connect your points by joining the lines together. Do not draw a best fit because it will never give you a nice best fit line. So just draw the line suitably like that. Okay, you may also curve the line with best fit. That is also correct, meaning if the graph is like that, you can just also make it this way, something like that. For example, only because this looks like a curve, you can see this looks like a curve. This one, you can also make go up and then continuously like that, something like that also can, but do not extrapolate it. Okay, extrapolate means do not extend the line unnecessarily. Once it stops here, stop here. Do not continue the line or the curve. Okay, so this is your 5 marks. Units are important, and also your volume unit here. Alright, Part 6, estimate the time taken to produce 3 centimeter cube of carbon dioxide at 35 degrees. So you refer this red graph, and I have already plotted 3 centimeter cube, and down it hits about 23. So here's 21, 22, 23. So the answer here will be 23 minutes. So you must show your graph, you must draw this line to show that indicate that you have already, that is the correct one. D, carbon dioxide gas was bubbled through hydrogen carbonate indicator solution. The indicator was red before the gas was bubbled through. State the color change that would occur. Okay, this is another tricky question if you not and do not familiarize with hydrogen carbonate solution. Hydrogen carbonate solution, very easy to remember the colors P, M, Roy. So P, it shows the lower CO2 concentration. Yellow shows the highest CO2 concentration. Okay, so once the CO2 concentration has bubbled inside and they said red color is the first one, meaning it's in the center, we can assume that it's in the middle. What happens if we add more CO2? It becomes either orange or yellow. So I can put yellow, I can also put orange. It's both acceptable answer. So this is the one mark. So question 2a, figure 2.1 shows an epidermal cell from a red onion. So they are most likely going to ask you to draw the very big, the large specimen diagram. So magnification here is stated as is times 340. Alright, so this is your large diagram. A few things to note, that make sure you do not shade anything. For example, there's one trick here that you should know, is that can you see the nucleus? The nucleus is in darker color. Do not shade the darker color into it, because that's considered as shading already. So just make sure that you have the shape of the cell wall, you have the correct projection of the cytoplasm, and the correct location of the nucleus. And make sure your cell, the diagram, is larger than the initial in the diagram itself also. Okay. And then part 2, say line PQ on figure 2.1 represents the length of cell X. Measure the length of the line PQ on figure 2.1. So just use your ruler to measure this. And then you times 10 if your ruler is in centimeter. So you just change it to millimeter. Then you divide it with the magnification, and you should get an answer of 0.229 in 3 significant figure. So that would be your final answer. Okay. B, water moves into and out of the cell by osmosis. Plan an investigation to determine the effect of concentration of CO2, so also sorry, of sodium chloride and solution on the osmosis in plant tissue. So the IV, they have already stated to you, this is the concentration of the sodium chloride. So you give 2 to 3 concentration need to be done in the investigation. And the DV, the dependent variable, is to of course measure the final mass of the plant tissue. Why? Because as you immerse it, the mass will change. So this is what you're going to measure. The method, of course, to start off with cutting the potato cubes. So using a potato is a very one good example for osmosis type experiments. So you cut the potato into cube-like shapes, and then with the same dimension, and then you measure the length and the mass before and after. The CB is to make sure you have the same variety of potato, and then same initial mass of the potato. So a lot more, you can have the same temperature, same volume of the sodium chloride solution, probably the same incubation time, type of onion. You can also use onion also, but then potato is the best because you can able to see how much it can shrink, how much it becomes softer in texture, something like that. Okay, and of course repeat, state your repeats of 2 to 3 more times, and then make sure you wear gloves and be careful to not get cut when you are cutting the potato cubes into cube like shapes. Okay. So that's the end of the paper. So I hope this time the explanation is much more clearer. And remember that if there are any questions, do type in the comment section below. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.